look, in today's video, man, I'm kind of excited for this, but at the same time, I know it's going to be kind of emotional for a lot of y'all. But today, we got Freddie Mercury before they were gone. So I'm actually like excited to know a little bit more about him before he passed away. But enough talking, we're going to go ahead and get right into this video. You already know what to do. If you are new to the channel, everything I do over here, man, is free 99. Free 99. That means you don't have to pay a damn cent. Well, actually, I just said free 99. Look, it's free, man. It's free. So go ahead and hit that subscribe button if you are new to the channel. Turn on post notifications while you're at it. Also, hit the like button, too. Run up the likes on this video. Without further ado, we're finna go ahead and check out this Freddie Mercury before they were gone. Let's check it out.
I understand that in Japan that you couldn't even leave your hotels. That's the
It was very difficult. Yeah.
In fact, yes, and we were reduced to traveling in laundry lifts and things like that.
Before Freddie Mercury was the subject of the upcoming Queen biopic, Bohemian Rhapsody.
It goes on forever.
Oh, Bohemian!
Your wife, if you think 6 minutes is forever.
Before Freddie Mercury was getting the recognition of astrophysicists,
the International Astronomical Union's Minor Planet Center renamed an asteroid after Freddie Mercury.
Before Bohemian Rhapsody became immortalized by Mike Myers and Dana Carvey. Before Freddie Mercury tragically passed away from complications with HIV.
Then on Sunday, the 45-year-old singer died of bronchopneumonia at his home in West London.
I thought it was eight. Well, I get. Oh, never mind. Never mind. Isn't those two different diseases? Maybe not. I don't know.
Here's a quick look back at the career of the first major rock star to succumb to the plague of AIDS.
Known throughout the world for his larger-than-life stage presence and powerful voice, Queen frontman Freddie Mercury has given us some of the most memorable music in history. From Bohemian Rhapsody to We Are the Champions to everyone's favorite sports anthem, We Will Rock You. His singing legacy has lasted throughout the decades, and it's hard to believe that as a kid, well, he had aspirations to become a boxer. Can you believe that? What's going on, guys? It's your boy Michael McCredden documenting the life and career of the world-famous Freddie Mercury here for you on Before They Are Gone. Now, we've done profiles on other music icons, a lot of them. I'm talking David Bowie, I'm talking Tupac, Bob Marley. Ooh. We've done a bunch. You can
browse around Bob Marley.
Our Before They Were Gone playlist for more. And as always, let us know who's next. Now, let's get into this music legend's bio. Here we go.
Oh, that baby Biggie?
Freddie Mercury was born Farouk Balsara on September 5th, 1946 in Zanzibar. Now at the time, this was a British colony, but is now part of Tanzania. His father, Bami, an Indian man of Persian descent, worked for the British Ministry of Foreign Affairs. Now Farouk was reportedly a shy, introverted child with a strong attachment to his mother, Jair. But his dependency was challenged at 7 years old when his parents decided to send him to St. Peter's School in Bombay, India. Bye-bye, Mommy. As a young boy, Farouk was highly athletic, showing potential as a boxer very early on. His mother, however, felt the sport was too dangerous and eventually pressured him to take up another. Now, judging by some footage we found online, there's someone out there who closely resembles Freddie in the ring, but, well, this person was probably happy they took his mom's advice. I can't confirm 100% that that is Freddie or it isn't Freddie. Looks a whole lot like him. Anyway, from there, Farouk, well, he switched to everyone's favorite sport, ping pong. Yeah, now if you think for a second he didn't take that seriously, he became school champ at just 10. Eat that, Forrest Gump.
For some reason, ping pong can
This man been a legend since he was in
that sports were middle school. Passion okay. Farouk also demonstrated a strong interest in music, learning piano as well as entering the school choir. Soon enough, Mercury was playing in his first musical group called the Hectics, a band of Indian influence that would soon make rounds playing at schools, dances, and parties. Probably picking up all the chicks. We're not there yet. It was around this time that the name Farouk went away and his friends and bandmates began referring to him as Freddie. He graduated from school at the age of 17 and returned to his family in Zanzibar, but due to Zanzibar's revolution just 2 years later, the family was forced to leave the island, making a new home for themselves in Middlesex, England. Now, Freddie did not leave his music behind, and it was during this time that bands like The Who, Led Zeppelin, and The Rolling Stones, well, they were taking over the world. Freddie studied these artists at the same time he attended the Ealing Art College, located in London. After graduating Graduating in 1989 from studying art and graphic design, Freddie joined a rock band in Liverpool known as Ibex. While the group was short-lived, he tried out several more while selling street paintings and secondhand clothing just to keep a few bucks in his pocket. In 1970, Freddie, along with drummer Roger Taylor and guitarist Brian May, they were experimenting with a band called Smile. The band was another failure, but Freddie urged the guys to form a new group. Recruiting bassist John Deacon and altering his stage name to Freddie Mercury, well, the band that we now know as Queen, well, it was born. Let's just take a second and talk about the Queen logo. As it turns out, the iconic symbol was the brainchild of the frontman himself. The symbols being the zodiac signs of the four members,
So that's the Queen logo? I never seen the Queen logo. I didn't even know they had a logo. That's actually a dope logo. That's really a dope logo. I've never seen
it. It was for Roger and John, a Cancer for Brian, and the Virgo for Freddie. The phoenix shown above the sign symbolizes the birth of a new band out of the ashes of old ones. Okay. In 1970, Freddie met Mary Austin, who he lived with for 7 years. The song Love of My Life is dedicated to her. Before they edited their first album, Freddie released a song called I Can Hear Music under the name Larry Lurix. In 1973, the band signed to the label Trident and Emmy. Soon enough, their debut album, Queen, was released. Followed a year later by their sophomore album, simply titled Queen 2, as well as their third entitled Killer Queen. It wasn't until 1975, A Night at the Opera, where the song Bohemian Rhapsody was unveiled to the masses. If you never heard it, well, that also means you've never seen Wayne's World, which is like a total double fail on your part. The song sat on British charts for over 9 weeks and sold 3 million copies. Outside of its fun-loving and catchy melody, Bohemian Rhapsody is noted for its unusual length. At 5 minutes and 55 seconds, the song received very little radio play initially. Since they were living, you know, in the Stone Age before the internet, the track would only gain momentum after the purchase of the album. Along with the song's popularity, its promo video is also considered groundbreaking, as many historians credit it as influencing what is now the modern day music video. Queen was without a doubt one of the biggest musical acts the world had ever seen.
Yes,
with Freddie Mercury talent becoming increasingly more evident with songs like Somebody to Love, We Will Rock You, and We Are the Champions. Now at the time, it was common for artists to hold concerts in theaters as well as old basketball arenas, but Queen, they took it to a whole other level, with their spectacular live sets and pyrotechnics wowing audiences around the world. Freddie was known for stating...
That's one thing I really want to know, because I know that Queen, their live performances was amazing. But I never watched Michael Jackson's live performance. I heard that his live performance was amazing. But honestly, I want to know who live performance was better, Queen or Michael Jackson. I never watched Michael Jackson's live performance. I might have to do that.
Concert is not a live rendition of our album. It's a theatrical event. Towards the end of the 1970s, Freddie Mercury's love affair with Mary Austin would unfortunately come to a close. This would contribute to speculation about the artist's sexual orientation, with rumors suggesting he was gay. Many fans, as well as TV and radio stations, reacted with prejudice. His physical appearance also saw drastic change as his short hair and grown mustache, it imitated an aesthetic popular to gay men at the time. The rumors spiraled even more when the video for I Wanna Break Free was released, featuring all four members dressed as women. Although many interpreted the move to simply be a humorous gag of the video clearly spoofing British TV show Coronation Street. What do you think? Believe it or not, this legendary appearance was succeeded that following year when the band hit up Wembley yet again. This was for the Magic Tour.
So Freddie was gay?
In his last ever concert as the head of Queen, Freddie showed the world why he was reigning king of rock and roll as 15 cameras and a helicopter recorded the madness. Not long after, Freddie would travel to Barcelona to meet with Spanish soprano Montserrat Cabelli to help record the Barcelona theme for the 1992 Olympic Games. This proved to be one of the final triumphs of Freddie's career, as later on that year, he would become HIV positive. And these were the results of what was rumored to be a promiscuous sex life. While the news proved to be that of his greatest fear, Freddie kept his illness under wraps, once again only telling those closest to him. The last time he was seen on stage was in 1988, when he performed alongside Montserrat in Barcelona as part of La Nuit Festival. Freddie spent his final years in seclusion, locking himself inside his London home, where he would continue to write and compose music despite his deteriorating health. On February 4th, 1991, Queen's final album, entitled Innuendo, it was released, with lyrics and vocals certainly reflecting Freddie's current state. On November 23rd, 1991, Freddie decided that it was time to announce to the world that he had been HIV positive for the last 4 years. The following day, the legendary performer passed away at the age of 45.
Wait, first off, I got two things. Wait, so this man was HIV positive for 4 years straight. He passed away at 45? That's young, bro. 45 is not even old. That man passed away young. Oh, man, that's crazy. Wow. I'm in shock. I didn't know he was gay. I did not know he passed away at 45. Bro, that man passed away at a young age. Like, I think if he was still alive, he could have lived until, like, 70, 80. Almost.
His partner of 6 years, Jim Hutton, well, he was said to be at his bedside.
There have been tributes to his talent and his courage from friends and from fans.
He was better than almost any other performer in holding a live audience in the palm of his hand.
Despite his tragic loss, Freddie Mercury's legacy lives on through his music, as well as his countless live recordings, along with a posthumous Queen album, as well as a spot in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. This singer has inspired artists across the globe, including many you know and love today. With everything they've accomplished, it's a relief, Freddie. Well, he didn't stick with ping pong. Or boxing. As for the rest of the story, like I said, it lives on through his music and his loved ones, because this is before they're gone. Here are a few more videos that we've handpicked that you may appreciate if you enjoyed this video. As always, let us know who's next. My name is Michael McCrudden. See you guys in another video.
First of all, I didn't know that Freddie was gay. I would never thought this man Freddie was honestly gay. That just shocked me. That really just shocked me. Like, okay, I react to this video when he had the wig. I thought that was just his hair. I thought he was just having a long hair, but now I realized the lipstick. I'm thinking, okay, that's just how they was back in the day. That man was gay. Okay, he was gay. He died at 45. Freddie had actually, that's crazy. This man had a career. He had a career, man. But anyways, that's crazy, man. That's wild. That man Freddie really had a career, man. That man was... And he was in his prime, too. Like, he died at a young age. He was in his prime, bro. It wasn't like he was super old. That man was still in his prime. That is wild to me. Anyways, man, that was before they were gone. Freddie Mercury, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Hit that like button. Subscribe to the channel. You guys are new, man. I do videos like this on a daily basis. If you guys haven't already, go check out my previous videos. Without further ado, it's been your boy, Depan. God bless. Peace.